Anatomical landmarks are features on the surface of the tooth which are either elevations or depressions. These landmarks help the tooth in performing their functions and also in their identification. Here, we will be discussing the landmarks showing only convexity or elevation. Cusp. Cusp is an elevation on the crown portion of a tooth making up a divisional part of the occlusal surface. Each cusp represents a developmental lobe of the tooth. Cusps are present on the occlusal surface of all molars, premolars, and on the incisal surface of canines. There are different numbers of cusps in different teeth. Canines have one cusp, premolars have two cusps, except for mandibular second premolar, which may have two or three cusps. Maxillary and mandibular first molars have five cusps, and second molars have four cusps. The cusps are named according to their location on the tooth. For example, in premolars, one on the lingual side is lingual cusp, one on the buccal side is buccal cusp. Another example, in molars, they are on four corners of the occlusal surface. So, mesiobuccal cusp, distobuccal cusp, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp. The shape of the cusp is like a four-sided pyramid. This shape is due to the four ridges running from the cusp tip in different directions. Two cuspal ridges, one mesial cuspal ridge and one distal cuspal ridge. Then one ridge which runs to the cervical line, it may be buccal ridge or lingual ridge depending on the surface on which it is present. And one triangular ridge running towards the center of the occlusal surface. Cingulum. Cingulum is a mound or elevation on the cervical third of the lingual surface of anterior teeth. In a tooth formed of four lobes, it is the lingual developmental lobe that forms the cingulum. Cingulum is seen in all maxillary incisors, mandibular incisors and in all canines. They are always on the lingual surface and are limited in the cervical third. If we compare their sizes, the largest cingulum is seen in maxillary canine. Ridges. Ridge is a linear elevation on the tooth. They are named according to their location or shape or direction on the crown. First, labial or buccal ridge. They are present on all canines and on all premolars. It is a ridge that runs on the facial surface from cusp tip to the cervical line. In canines, they are called labial ridge. In premolars, they are called buccal ridge. Lingual ridge. It is a ridge seen in canines and premolars and runs on the lingual surface. In canines, it runs from the cusp tip to the cingulum and splits the lingual fossa into two. In premolars, it runs from the lingual cusp tip to the cervical line. Next, incisal ridge. This ridge is present in all incisors. It is a ridge which runs mesiodistally on the incisal surface between the mesioincisal angle and distoincisal angle. With continuous use, the ridge loses its convexity and becomes sharp. Then, it is called as incisal edge. Next, cuspal ridge. It is seen in all teeth with cusps, that is, all molars, premolars and canines. It runs from the cusp tip in the proximal direction. Each cusp has two cuspal ridges, one mesial cuspal ridge, one distal cuspal ridge. Next, marginal ridge. It is the only ridge which is present in all teeth. It runs on the proximal borders of the tooth. In each tooth, there are two marginal ridges. One mesial marginal ridge, one distal marginal ridge. In anterior teeth, they are present on the lingual surface and in posterior teeth, they are present on the occlusal surface. Cervical ridge. It is seen in all molars. It is a ridge which runs mesiodistally in the cervical third of the buccal surface. In comparison, they are more prominent in deciduous molars than permanent molars. Triangular ridge. It is present in all premolars and molars. It is a ridge running from the cusp tip towards the center of the occlusal surface of the crown. They are so called because of the shape made by the slopes of the ridge. They are named according to the cusp from which they are originating, like buccal triangular ridge or lingual triangular ridge. Transverse ridge. It is seen in all premolars and molars. It is not a separate ridge but formed by the combination of two triangular ridges. It crosses the occlusal surface transversely in buccolingual direction. Lastly, the oblique ridge. This ridge is present on all maxillary molars. This is also not a separate ridge, but formed by the combination of triangular ridge of distobuccal cusp and distal ridge of mesiolingual cusp. It crosses the occlusal surface obliquely. Finally, mammelons. Mammelons are three protuberances present on the incisal surface of a newly erupted permanent incisor. They are seen in all permanent incisors. They are formed by the three developmental lobes which form the labial surface of incisors, namely the mesial, labial and distal developmental lobes. That is why they are always three in number. With continuous use of the tooth, the mammelons disappear, making the incisal ridge straight. Mammelons are not present in deciduous incisors and are many times used as a feature to differentiate a permanent incisor from a deciduous incisor in children.